Welcome to Alan East Business Academy. In this lesson, you're going to learn how to solve for the present value. First of all, the present value reflects the current worth of a future sum of money given a specified rate of return. Translated into plain English, we're expecting some money to be paid at a later date, and we want to know what it's worth today. Due to the time value of money, we know that the money that we have today is worth more than that same amount of money in the future. This is due to a number of different reasons, including inflation and opportunity costs. So in order to make an accurate assessment, we engage in this process of discounting, which means we reduce the value of a future sum of money to account for the time value of money and determine its equivalent worth today. Say a friend of ours was offering to pay us $500 2 years from now if we were to lend him $450 today. Because of the time value of money, we immediately know that this $500 doesn't hold the value of $500 today. But how much is it actually worth today? To see if we're getting a fair deal, we need to solve for the present value. Just so you have a visual of what we're doing here, I'm going to draw a timeline showing the process of discounting. When I was learning this concept myself, I found it was helpful to have a visual representation of the process. So hopefully, this helps you as well. Here we have the $500 that we expect to receive 2 years from now, and we need to discount it to today to see how much it's really worth. On the left side, in parentheses, which denotes a negative value, we have the $450 that we may loan our friend. The next thing we need to know is the interest rate that we'll be using to discount our future monies. If you're solving for the present value as part of a class exercise or maybe even an exam, then the interest rate is usually provided. Unfortunately, real life doesn't work this way. We need to actually determine a reasonable interest rate. A good way to look at this is by asking yourself, what interest rate could we earn on those monies if we had them in our possession? Let's say that we figure this to be 5% annually. We now have everything needed to solve for the present value, except the equation, of course. To solve for the present value, we need to divide our future value by the result of 1 plus I to the nth power. Now let me briefly explain each of the variables that we have here. Our future value, which is represented by the letters FV, is the sum of money or cash flows that we expect to receive in the future. For us, this is the $500 that our friend is promising to pay. The little I represents the interest rate that we'll use to discount our monies. One note of importance is that we need to convert all percentages into decimal form to perform the calculations accurately. So instead of using 5%, we'll actually be using 0.05. Lastly, you'll notice that we have a lowercase n, which represents the number of periods that will discount our future value. The reason that I say periods and not years is that we can choose to discount our value by years, quarters, months, weeks, or really any duration of our choosing. However, if you're going to do that, you must also change the interest rate for the increased number of periods. We'll talk more about this in future lessons. Now that we understand the equation and have each of the required variables, we're ready to solve for the present value. First, let's plug our values into their respective variables. Directing our attention first to the denominator of our equation, we add 1 to 0.05 to get 1.05, and 1.05 squared equals 1.1025. Lastly, we divide our future value of 500 by 1.1025 to get $453.52 after rounding to the nearest hundredth. Congratulations, you've just solved for the present value. But what exactly does this value mean to us? What this means is that the $500 that we expect to receive 2 years from now, discounted by 5% compounded annually, is the equivalent of $453.52 today. So technically, this deal makes financial sense. For one, we're earning slightly over 5% annually on our original $450. And to make it even better, we get to help out our friend. Let's just hope he actually pays us back. Thanks for watching this lesson on the present value. If you want to learn more, then subscribe to Alan East Business Academy for access to over 150 free lessons on topics ranging from accounting to statistics. And download our podcast for free on iTunes. Thanks for watching.